I'm here with my baby, Mellie. She hadn't done a video with us for a while now, but I enjoy when she does decide to come and do them because it helps her in learning too. I mean, we teach her things here in the house, but when we're doing the videos too, just her sitting here absorbing, and also, you know, we've had a lot of people encourage us and encourage her in learning about what's going on with our country. So anyway, I just wanted to do a quick video. I wanted to first say that we won. Yesterday we won. But I was listening to, it's a collaboration of some Christian rappers that we listened to. And they had one particular rapper, I think it was Andy Mineo, who we don't listen to like a lot of his music, but we listen to some of his music. We, you know, have to chew and spit out the pieces we don't like, you know, because some of his stuff is really good and then some of his stuff not so good. And we listen to a variety of different types of music. And in this one song, he said, "Thank God it's Monday." He said, I'd be like, "Thank God it's Monday. I got to get back to work." And that's what I wanted to talk to us about today. I wanted to talk to us about, we got to get back to work. Yesterday was fun. We had a great time yesterday. You want to share what we did yesterday
in Daddy celebration? Daddy barbecued, and yeah, we were celebrating that we won. Yeah. Victory!
Yes, thank God, because it's about her future, you know. I went on, did a little silly dance. You know, I always do silly dances around the house. I do the shoot, with my kids and all their little dances and embarrass the heck out of them. I do it in front of their friends. We were in Buffalo Wild Wings one day. They were just dancing. I was dancing too. So anyway, I wanted to discuss why the SCOTUS is so important, why this was such a victory for us, is that number one, they're in a capacity at this point in time that they should have never been in to begin with. The Democrats are the ones that actually made us so dependent on them, because we saw and we have learned that they use the Supreme Court of the United States to be an end-all to be-all, to push their agenda. And so when we see that, we need to fight back. We have to fight back. So they showed us the importance of who is sitting in that high court, the highest court of our land. And so I'm looking at my notes over here like I always try to do. So we want to beat them at their own game. And then I wanted to point out that, you guys, they redefined, they used the Supreme Court to redefine an age-old word back in the Bible, the most circulated book known to man, brought from the oldest of scrolls known to man. They redefined what marriage was, okay? In the Bible, it says male and female created he them. You know, one man, one woman. That argument always held up in court. No one could knock it down, but they kept trying. And once they had the balance that they wanted in there, they were able to go in there and redefine it. And not to mention the worst atrocity that they could have ever done, which is millions of babies are being murdered in our country daily, you know? So they use these things to their advantage. And so I wanted to say that that was a battle. We're hoping that Ruth Bader Ginsburg is out of there soon. And we're hoping that President Trump will be able to tilt the balance of power a little bit more in the conservatives' favor. And hopefully that will be with Amy Barrett, who I identify with in a lot of ways as a mother, conservative mother, of a large family. So anyway, I wanted to touch on the Blacks for Trump. I heard President Trump saying 35% of Blacks, or 36% now, actually, when I looked at the polls earlier, of Blacks are for President Trump now. I honestly believe that that number is a lot higher, as I have, you know, looked at how our circle personally has become more of Trump supporters, you know, Blacks, meaning, and then also some Hispanics that we're friends with. We know that we were responsible in encouraging a lot of people to go ahead and feel comfortable being President Trump supporters as they realized that their beliefs and their views really aligned with much of what he wanted to see our country look like. They wanted the very same thing. So anyway, I wanted to talk about that, and I wanted to point out that a lot of Black Trump supporters, a lot of Hispanic Trump supporters are closeted, okay? And there's a reason for that. My husband tells me, don't go outside with your MAGA hat on unless I'm with him. You know, my husband's a pretty big dude. Nobody's gonna mess with me when I'm with him. I wear it out often when I'm with him. But when I'm not, he tells me, don't even do it, honey, you know, so I don't. And so I can only imagine what a lot of other people are feeling, you know, and those that don't have the big muscle behind them, the big husband like I do, big daddy, huh? Anyway, I wanted to encourage us that yesterday was fun. It was wonderful. But now today, like I started out with, it's time to roll up our sleeves. We have a lot to do. That was a battle. That was one. We might have another one. If Bader Ginsburg needs to be removed or whatever happens with her, every picture I see of her now, she's sleeping and passed out and stuff. So I don't think she has much longer. So we need to build our wall, okay? And at very least, we need to have people in there that are going to support the president in getting this shift of power at SCOTUS. And first, starting out with the states, that's the pathway I see. Other people might see another pathway. I know everybody wants, you know, marriage redefined again back to what it was. And everybody wants to see Roe v. Wade, including the woman that was used for it, you know, God rest her soul now, that they used as a guinea to push their demonic agenda. I know everyone wants to see it overturned like yesterday, but the pathway that I see would be to have it at the state levels first. Most of the states of the United States of America are going to ban it altogether when they are given that authority to do so. Most states are, and especially if they give the power to the people, okay? And it's, you know, on a fair basis, because most folks, when they understand that that's a baby and they have that education, most folks don't want to see babies being murdered, okay? So anyway, I wanted to lay that out there, why it's so important, that pathway that I see, you know, with the new SCOTUS. And then I also wanted to encourage you guys, personal contact. Daniel and I have seen a lot of success in our videos, Facebook, we get, you know, PMs from people and stuff. We get direct messages and stuff from people. So we know that we're seeing the effectiveness of using social media. But I think that the most effective is that personal contact, talking to folks in your circle that are on the fence or on the other side, telling them why you believe as you do, and discussing the commonality between yourself and them, the views that you both have. And we've seen a lot of success in that. So anyway, I just want to encourage, again, battle is won, war is not. A lot more work to do to protect our country. We still have the wall. We need Senate and Congress that's going to back our president. And we know that the SCOTUS is going to be appointing someone else again. Thank you, and God bless y'all.
Bye.